we're going to be talking about detoxing and cleansing the Beyond Organic way. Now, first thing here I wanted to get into is health in America today. Now, you guys may already know this. Look at some of these stats. 70% of Americans are overweight. In fact, the obesity rates today, which if somebody is obese, it means they're actually, it's life-threateningly overweight, is 34% of Americans. Think about that, one out of every three people. And the average middle-aged weight gain of an American is 22 pounds. If you gain 22 pounds, which is the average middle-aged weight gain, doubles your risk of a heart attack, triples your risk of cancer. On the flip end, one of the things you heard Jordan say earlier is, as being part of Beyond Organic, we have an opportunity to save lives. And think about this. On the flip end, if you help somebody by helping them eat these foods, by spreading this message, if you have one person lose 20 pounds, you've just reduced the risk of cancer by 75%, reduced the risk of a heart attack by 50%. As a person who's had a mom who's had cancer twice, I can tell you that's a really, really big deal to have someone in your family or someone that you really care about not get one of those conditions. This is staggering. 10% of the population over 50 years old has dementia or they're developing dementia and Alzheimer's. That's incredible, 10%. Unbelievable. ADHD in both children and adults has grown 400% in the past 20 years. 40% of Americans will get cancer, and 80% of Americans today say they struggle with fatigue. I'll tell you, that's one of the biggest things I see, and I know the physicians in the room will tell you the same thing. How many people today have low energy levels? I'll tell you, energy drinks are going through the roof. In fact, energy drinks, I think, last year alone grew like $9 billion in sales. And so, obviously, there's a lot of fatigue going on in America. So just these things alone, and all of these things, are things really by eating what we're talking about, a biblically organic-based, Beyond Organic diet, can really help with many of these things we're talking about. Look at this. This is unbelievable. Now, you'd think that, okay, maybe our kids aren't that toxic, but adults are because of all of our exposures over time. The American Red Cross examined the umbilical cord blood of 10 newborn babies and found an average of 287 chemicals already in babies that were born. 180 of the chemicals were found to cause cancer, 217 toxic to the brain, and 208 can potentially cause birth defects. And so already early on, and so, you know, I work with a lot of pregnant mothers as well, and I tell them, you know what, whatever you eat, whatever you put in your body goes into the baby. And so my, you know, you've heard the phrase eating for two, which is very true. My mentor, one of my old mentors used to say, you know what, really all the time we're eating for three. We're eating for God, we're eating for ourselves, and we're eating for our family. And that's really one of the principles we want to be going
Amen.
By. Now, when we're talking about detoxification, because obviously toxicity is a major, major problem today. It's a cause of many diseases today. But when we're talking about detoxification, we really have to look at your body at the cellular level. So this is a picture of a cell. And your body is actually made up of over 75 trillion cells. And so if you want to be healthy, we actually have to look at you at a cellular level and actually get all of your cells healthy. Now, I actually meant to put this a little bit later in the slides, but I just want to talk about doing cleansing. So what I'm going to be talking about tonight is cleansing your body at a cellular level. Now, this is a guy here, Don, did a three-day cleanse, which we'll talk about at the end. And just by doing a simple three-day cleanse, his blood pressures improved significantly in just 3 days, resting heart rate dropped, lost 5 pounds in just 3 days, energy went up, and he said just 3 days, already saw those kinds of changes in his body. So we'll talk about that more as we go. But again, there's a lot to be said for cleansing. Also, you know, looking at things like, if you've heard of a Daniel fast, doing something like that. I mean, I really am a huge believer in doing periodic fasts, and especially doing it with things like we'll talk about, like cultured whey, fruits and vegetables, things along those lines. But again, cleansing and fasting is biblical in so many ways. Now, this is a pretty strong statement, but it's the truth. The cause of really all disease is when your cells either become toxic or deficient. So either you have too many toxins in your cells or your cells are deficient in something like vitamins, minerals, antioxidants. And so when I have people come to my clinic or call my radio show or anything else and they're asking for help in their health, I really try and simplify it, and it really is as simple. We've got a few problems going on. You've got too many toxins in your system, and you're deficient in stuff. And so we really need to fix those two imbalances when it comes to getting you healthy. And so here's another amazing quote here that's going to kind of apply to what we're going to talk about. A two-time Nobel Prize winner, his name was Otto Warburg, he said, "The cause of cancer is no longer a mystery." He says, "We know it occurs when any cell is denied 60% of its oxygen requirements." So if a cell can't breathe, if it's suffocating, it actually creates new receptor sites and actually becomes cancerous if you have the certain genes. But that's what can happen if your cell doesn't have enough oxygen. That's when the cell can become cancerous. Let's talk about, well, what causes oxygen depletion in your cell? Toxins that we're talking about here, look at this. Toxicity and acidity is one major thing, so acidity in many of the foods. Most of our meat today is more highly acidic because it's grain-fed. Toxicity, a lot of the chemicals in our food supply. Smoking, that's highly toxic. Chlorine, you know, our tap water supply, according to Patricia Hunt, she's a professor at Washington State University, she said there's over 300 different chemicals and medications in our water supply today. Things even like birth control, statin drugs, chlorine, fluoride, all of those are in our tap water. So getting good, clean water is also very important. And so, but all of these things cause oxygen depletion. So I want to talk about the solution here, actually after this slide. So here's how to think of it. We're talking about cellular health. This is a good, healthy cell. This is a bad cell. In a good, healthy cell, things can get in and out of your cell very easily. So basically, it's like you've ever heard that, you know, that your body is basically like a stream of water. It's a river. And your body, according to Guyton's medical physiology, is made up of around 70% pure water. So your body is almost entirely water. So as long as things are getting in and out of your cell, if you are, again, the water is moving really well, just like in a fast-moving stream, you're healthy. However, what happens in a bad cell is hardly anything gets in, hardly anything gets out. It becomes like swamp water, becomes stagnant. That's a sick cell. And that really is really an important aspect to get, is that if you're going to be healthy, things in and things out, vitamins and nutrients in, your cell flushes toxins out in a bad cell. And so what this basically is, this is how it works too, you know, these toxins around here, this is chlorine. This is those hormones in the meat. This is heavy metals in our environment. This is, you guys tracking with me? And so nothing can get in or out of your cell. In order to get your cell healthy, we've got to be able to remove those toxins and flush them out of your cell. And toxins don't disappear without help, okay? Your body actually needs certain nutrients to flush all the toxins out. Now, here are the main things. If you want to know, okay, how do I cleanse? If I'm really looking to cleanse my system, how do I do that? Number one is water. It really is. I'll tell you, I think a good majority of Americans today are really deficient in really, you know, one of the most abundant resources on the planet, and that's H2O. Let me say this, though. It is rare to find good quality water today. I mean, you look at, you know, I was just talking to a friend of mine in Nashville. We have a ministry there called Blood Water Mission, and they're one of the largest ministries in the world bringing water over to Africa. I went on a mission trip to Africa a couple years ago, and that was the biggest thing there. I mean, they're starting to dig wells now, but clean water. I mean, did you know, I think it's like one out of every five people don't have access to clean water. Actually, the numbers may be higher than that, but it's unbelievable. Now, believe it or not, in America today, do we have a problem with a lot of bad bacteria in our water supply? Not as much as in somewhere like Africa, but do we have a major problem with chemicals in our water supply? Absolutely. There's a way to measure how clean your water is, and it's called TDS level. It stands for total dissolved solids. So those solids are chemicals in your water supply. Anything over 200 is really bad in terms of water. Even some of our best water, even some of our bottled water today by places like Dasani, like the Pepsi company, the water has around a 2,000 TDS level. Now, Jordan went and tested 21 different springs all across America to really try and find the purest water in America, and he found the water in the Blue Ridge Mountains of Georgia, Beyond Organic. Also, we're not going to talk about this much tonight, but they actually do have water as well at a TDS level of 3, the lowest that they've ever tested in a spring. And so, again, getting good, clean water is vital for your health, and you have to have it if you're going to cleanse at a cellular level. Also, electrolytes, okay? Electrolytes are certain types of vitamins and minerals. Some of the ones that you are most familiar with, sodium, which most Americans aren't deficient in, but the last three are probably the three vitamins and minerals that Americans are most deficient in, potassium, magnesium, and good quality calcium. Those are things that most Americans are very deficient in. So if you're going to detox, you need to get electrolytes. I'm going to get more in depth with that here in a minute. Another big thing is probiotics. Probiotics are known as good bacteria. In fact, this is kind of amazing. Your body has 10 times more bacteria in it than cells. So we talked about your body is made up of 75 trillion cells. In your gut alone, you have 750 trillion cells, or 750 different types of bacteria in your gut. So you need good quality water, H2O, you need electrolytes, you need probiotics in order to cleanse your cells, and also you need to eliminate toxic foods and chemicals. If you do those things, you are cleansing and your body's able to heal. Here's the truth, your body has an amazing capacity to heal. As long as there aren't things interfering with it, and as long as your cells are healthy, your body can heal. Now, I'm going to talk a little bit about Suero Gold, and this also applies to all the Beyond Organic product. It's called Suero Vive. But really what is in there, it's called Cultured Whey. And Hippocrates, who is known as the father of modern medicine, he called Cultured Whey healing water. It's what he gave all of his patients to get healthy. He gave them Cultured Whey.